52 magazine on the USS Cassin Young, one of the magazines supplying one of the five-inch guns here on the ship. Now, this magazine consists of two chambers. The first chamber is the powder magazine. Men in there, sealed off to minimize exposure, are going to pass through 28-pound casings of powder through the scuttle to go into a hoist, to be sent up two decks above us to an upper handling room, where there another crew will send the powder to the gun crew inside the gun. In this chamber, men are not only operating the hoist, but they're also taking shells from this chamber, also placing it in the hoist, and sending up whatever they're ordered to bring up. Now, we're three decks down from the main deck. It's the safest part of the ship, but it's also the most dangerous, because when this ship was active, we'd be surrounded by hundreds and hundreds of pounds of high explosives.
This is an ammunition handling room for one of our 5-inch gun mounts on the deck above us. Directly above us is a 5-inch gun, which is the largest gun on the USS Cassin Young. Normally during a battle, you're going to have up to 11 sailors in this compartment. In this particular case, two decks below us are the powder magazines. Down there are five sailors in the bottom of this hoist. The shells and the powder are all coming up in this hoist. Now, some of the 11 guys are taking the shells and putting in the ready service. Some are putting powder in the ready service right there. But when the gun is ready to start firing, sailors take these canisters and they open them up. And inside these canisters are these powder cases. Now, every powder case weighs approximately 30 pounds. One sailor stands on this platform. He continuously reaches down, grabs a 30-pound powder shell, and by hand, shoves it through that hole in the deck above. And the shells go up in the chain hoist here. And these are going up 15 to 20 times every minute also. Every time the gun on the deck above us rotates left or right, everything in the center of this room rotates with it. So if your job is to put the shell in this hoist isn't always going to be here. It's going to be in some 180-degree turn, and you still need to get 15 to 20 rounds every minute up to that gun. This is an extremely dangerous compartment.
Now we're in the number 55 gun mount, or the fifth gun mount on the ship. Inside this chamber, you would have at least seven men firing, readying, aiming, doing everything needed to fire this gun indefinitely under the most adverse conditions. Now, aiming and firing the gun, ideally, none of the pointing, none of the training, none of the range finding actually happens in this gun. It happens in the gun director on the very top of the ship. Automatic control means this gun can be moving at will, trying to track a target in the sky, moving at some 200 miles an hour. If that system breaks down, or if there's a problem and the computer is not sending a signal successfully to one of the guns, then you flip it to local control. One half of the crew is dedicated to what's called pointing, training, and range finding. On the left side of the gun here, a pointer is going to use hydraulic assistance and, if necessary, mechanical assistance if the hydraulics go out to elevate and decline the barrel of the gun. On the opposite side is a trainer doing the same thing but moving the gun left to right. They have to work together to track a target, and then standing up on this platform, the gun captain is going to be ranging in on a target. He sends the range to a rangefinder who helps adjust the scope to how many thousands of yards the target's away. Once they do all that, we're ready to fire the gun, which a whole other side of the crew is working on. Powder man's taking powder up from the scuttle out of the hands of the man right below him in the upper handling room. Hoisting up this 28-pound charge, he's going to place it at the bottom of the slide up against the spade that's going to ram it all in. Now the shell man, he's taking the shell out of the hoist, pre-programmed with the range to time it so that in the number of seconds it takes to reach the target, it'll explode. He takes the shell, rolls it in front of the charge, and then slams down on the rammer. The whole charge slams inside, and when the gun fires, the whole gun will recoil and eject the only thing left, the hot casing that's now been extended. A hot shell man, the final man in the team, wears asbestos gloves, catches the shell, and disposes of it as quickly as possible. It could roll around the deck, it could fall in the sea, it doesn't matter as long as it's away from the next charge of powder coming up to fire again. The men could fire 15 plus rounds a minute, but you had to be dedicated, trained, and you had to be strong to work under these adverse conditions. We're in a tin can, it's sitting out in the open sun, and these men would have to work hours and hours, if need be, at general quarters to operate just one of these five 5-inch guns.